You have been requesting Popeyes review for very long time. So here it is, Popeyes 2004 review. If you watched my Ubuntu 2004 review, you probably already know that I was very impressed with this release. So I wondered what Popeyes would offer to impress us even more. And Popeyes has several features that make great Ubuntu 2004 even better as a Popeyes. And in this review, I would like to compare Popeyes and Ubuntu 2004. Let's get started. Popeyes has a different installer, and I like it more for several reasons. First, its look is more appealing. Maybe it is because I am tired of Ubuntu's Ubiquiti installer. I believe it is because Popeyes installer is more modern overall. For example, look at this screen where you asked about the installation type. Isn't it beautiful? Here is how this tab looks in Ubuntu. It is fine, but Popeyes is much better. Also, Popeyes installer offers an obvious choice to encrypt your system. There are no technical details, you just need to select between these two buttons. While Ubuntu hides this option in the advanced settings, new Ubuntu users may want to encrypt their system. But first, they need to find this option, second, they would wonder what LVM is and if it's safe to use, especially next to the other option that is marked as experimental. It is in advanced settings after all. Being very user-friendly, the Popeyes installer also offers some advanced features. I was positively surprised to find Gparted as a partition manager. I believe Gparted is the best manager out there. It has all possible options you may need to configure your partitions, including resizing existing partitions without losing the data on those partitions. I have covered it in one of my videos. Overall, the installation experience is very intuitive and very fast. The system installed in 3 minutes, I configured a new user during the first login, and I was ready to use Popeyes 2004. The first thing you notice in Popeyes is of course the default GNOME shell layout. Unlike Ubuntu, which has this left dock panel, Popeyes looks very minimal and you have to open activities to find available apps and any open programs. The number of pre-installed apps is also very minimal, but you will find all essential apps here, including Office Suite, web browser, video player, and even email client. The only missing app is the music player, but you can play audio files in the video player if you don't want to install a music player. Popeyes has a dark theme by default, and this dark theme is little darker than Ubuntu's dark theme. I like the dark color scheme of Ubuntu little more, but Popeyes' dark theme is also pleasant. You can of course switch to the light theme. The setting is little hidden. In the appearance setting, you get the wallpaper view by default. And you need to click on this appearance button to change the theme. Here is the light theme. And I think Popeyes' light theme is better looking than Ubuntu's light theme. Popeyes' icons are much better in my view. But the major and probably a killing feature of Popeyes is the auto tiling window option. You enable it here in the top panel, and now whenever you open a window, it will automatically tile in the workspace. Such a feature is not available in Ubuntu by default. It is a little different concept of window management, but it is very helpful in the scenarios when you need to overview all open apps. Popeyes also provides launcher and apps feature, which you can invoke with super key and slash. It lists all open apps, you can select any of them, and you can also launch an installed app. If you are a more keyboard user, you will definitely enjoy Popeyes 2004. I like the auto tiling feature, and I can see where I would use it. While I don't find this launcher and apps feature very useful, I can get the same results by pressing the super key and opening the GNOME activities. I have an overview of all open apps, or launch a new one if I type its name. So the Popeyes launcher switcher is a duplication of the standard GNOME feature, just in minimal presentation. Popeyes now supports the system tray icons, which was not available before. You had to install an extension before to enable these icons, as I showed in my after installing Ubuntu 18.04 video. It is a new addition in Ubuntu 20.04 as well, I just forgot to mention it in my Ubuntu 20.04 review. I was also a little surprised to see that display settings have no choice for fractional scaling beyond 100 and 200%. while Ubuntu has introduced this smaller step scaling of 125, 150, and 175%. It seems that PopOS makes automatic scaling for high DPI screens with these two options enabled. Maybe System76 decided that it is not very stable yet, as I pointed out in my Ubuntu review, and hide these settings for now. Anyway, I prefer customization of display scaling in Ubuntu. PopOS does not collect or store any information from user installations and usage. You won't find any sending information option in the privacy settings, unlike in Ubuntu, where you can of course disable this collection of information in privacy diagnostics tab in the settings. But in PopOS, you don't need to do that. It is disabled by default. Another significant difference of PopOS, it uses Flatpak over Snap. You can clearly see that in the Software Center, also known as PopShop. It says right at the top that it offers you a Flatpak package to install by default. However, if you click on it, you can also choose a DAB package. I first was thrilled to see that. They do not hide any information on the package origin, as in Ubuntu Software Center, where you need to scroll down to the package information to find its source. Moreover, unlike in Ubuntu, where DAB and Snap packages have two entries in the Ubuntu Software Center, PopOS has one entry for KDE Live, with the choice of Flatpak and DAB. It is precisely how it should be done. Unfortunately, this feature seems to be in the transition stage, because many programs still have duplicated entries in PopOS. For example, Inkscape has two entries. There is a button that shows its source, but it has only one option, it's Flatpak here. But if we open the other entry, it is Debian. Let's hope this will be fixed, and all apps will have one entry with the choice of the source, as it is for KDE Live now. Speaking about Flatpak over Snap, I cannot say which one is better. I tried both and both work fine. They usually pick up the right desktop theme and work reliably. Flatpak seems to install and launch a little faster than Snap, but my experience with Flatpak and Snap is still limited. I prefer to use the Debian packages. Let me know in the comments what's better for you and why. If you do not find some apps in the PopShop, you can download and install a Debian package with Eddy installer. For example, you may like proprietary Chrome web browser over open source Chromium. PopOS automatically recognizes that it is a Debian package and offers you to install it with Eddy. Ubuntu doesn't have Eddy. It uses Ubuntu Software App for such an installation. However, it doesn't recognize the Deb package by default and offers you to open it as an archive. You need to choose Ubuntu Software manually. It may be a huge problem for new users, as they may not figure out how to install the third-party packages in Ubuntu. There is no such problem in PopOS. Double-click on the Deb package, always open it with Eddy. Eddy is probably the best graphical Deb installer nowadays, so thumb up to PopOS for it. PopOS also has the extension app installed by default. It is really nice, as it allows you to manage the GNOME extensions easily. You can also install it in Ubuntu, but it is not pre-installed by default. You can already see that PopOS tailored some extensions, as they have Pop in their names. They also customize other software. PopOS is claimed to have better graphics card support, but since there is no graphic driver manager, you probably need to install the graphics driver from the command line. On the other hand, Ubuntu has a graphical driver management application, which will of course make driver installation much easier. My system doesn't have any hardware that requires proprietary drivers, so I could not test how well it works. System76 also provides a custom firmware management system, but I believe it only works with the System76 hardware. Correct me if I'm wrong here. It detects nothing in my system. The driver management is probably the major uncertain issue I would point out in PopOS 2004. I also wish they provided a minimize button on Windows, as it is in Ubuntu. And the major issue why I still cannot switch to GNOME, there is no different view settings for different folders in the file manager. If you change these view settings, it changes globally for all folders. But it is a problem of GNOME and not PopOS or Ubuntu. Otherwise, PopOS is fantastic. Of course, it is built on top of Ubuntu, and it has all the advantages of Ubuntu plus some more. Although, I really liked Ubuntu 2004 release, I think I would install Pop!_OS instead of Ubuntu. What is your preference? Please let me know in the comments, and thank you for watching!